Hi all, Igor Ekimov is with you. Today we will look at the rebar cutter from the car tool company. Where to use it and how to use it. This tool allows you to cut reinforcement up to 16 millimeters in diameter, as well as cut rods made of non-hardened steel. The reinforcement cutter has knives made of forged steel of increased hardness, and also has a pump that develops pressure up to 10 tons. However, this cutter is small in size and weighs just under 4 kg. It is used both in construction and in everyday life. This tool is completely autonomous, it does not require electricity to operate. What is often useful is that it does not leave behind any debris and is quite quiet. The rebar cutter itself is relatively inexpensive. Most craftsmen can afford it. I left a link to the carver in the description. If you are interested in other tools for construction and repair, then subscribe to the channel and press the bell. Special thanks for your likes and reposts. The carver comes in this branded yellow case. The handle is shifted towards the center of gravity of the tool. It's amazing that even this was thought out. Open the latches. Let's open it. As you can see, the reinforcement cutter occupies almost the entire space of the case. There is a place for spare knives. The cutter itself is initially supplied in such a package. We're filming. The instrument itself is well painted and fairly well assembled. There are rubber handles at the ends to make it easier to use. Judging by the weight of the tool, they didn't skimp on steel. Where is this rebar cutter usually used? This is where there is no electricity to connect the angle grinder. Also where you can't get around with this grinder. Or when you need to do work quietly or without debris. You don't even need to change clothes to work with this cutter. I've already used this cutter a little. I tested it before filming. Now I will show how it works on video. Here are the rebar cutter knives themselves. These knives can be replaced as they wear out. The upper knife is unscrewed with this screw using a hexagon. And the lower knife unscrews here. To get here, you need to lift the knife a little. You can order knives from the same company where I purchased this rebar cutter. You will find a link to the company in the description. For example, we will cut the reinforcement that I bought recently. We measure its diameter. As you can see, the diameter of the reinforcement is slightly more than 14 millimeters. We install the fittings. We make sure that it is perpendicular to the knives. Close the valve and pump. At the same time, pieces of this reinforcement can fly apart at a fairly high speed. Therefore, we make sure that they do not hit us, or other people, or anything fragile. Let's download. This is the fittings. This is how we got the cut. Let's look at the knives themselves. They were not injured. To move the lower knife, open the valve and it freely falls down on its own. The rebar cutter can also be used at home. For example, I'll split this chain in half. This chain is quite thick and suitable for a large dog. Let's see. Diameter 4.5 millimeters. But I need to divide this chain in half. And I can do this with the help of this reinforcement cutter. To do this without a reinforcement cutter, I would then need an anvil with a chisel, or a vise with a hacksaw for metal. In doing so, I would probably damage the chrome plating of this chain. In this case, I will now determine the middle of the chain and cut along the welded seam. Now I have found the middle of the chain and have already clamped the link and now I will pump it. As you can see, the rebar cutter cut the chain link quite easily. Now we relieve the pressure. And all we have to do is remove this link with the help of pliers. This reinforcement cutter can be used as a bolt cutter. Or as a stud cutter for screeding formwork. But it is worth considering that they should not cut material made of hardened steel. It is more suitable for cutting reinforcement and metal rods. Made of low alloy, non-hardened steel, as well as for non-ferrous metals. Sometimes, among the old reinforcement, you come across rods that bend poorly, but spring well. This is just hardened reinforcement, and I don't recommend cutting it with this rebar cutter. I am quite pleased that I have such a rebar cutter. I especially like that it is completely autonomous and does not require electricity. And also the fact that when working with it you don't need to change clothes, since it doesn't create garbage. Write in the comments how much you liked this tool. If you have any questions, also write in the comments. I left a link to the tool in the description. Share the video with those who might find this tool useful. Subscribe to the channel so as not to miss new videos. Like, and see you in new and old videos.